Father Thomas Gorms, SDB, Fathers, Sister Mary Penavanal, the Assistant General, Sister Daisy Jacob, the Economic General, Sister Rose Paite, our former General Counselor, family members of Sister Emilia Turki, especially her nephews, sisters, friends, and well-wishers to this Eucharistic celebration. At this moment, it is fitting to recall to mind the goodness of the Lord manifested in the life of our dear Sister Emilia Turki. Sister Sidney Matthew, the Provincial Superior of Mary Immaculate Promise, Kolkata, will now give us a concise picture of the person of Sister Emilia.
Gracious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. Psalm 116, verse 15. Death is an unescapable reality. The life of a Christian lies beyond death. The resurrected Christ teaches us that our life is not just confined to this perishable world, but rather we hope in the life eternal. The life and death of each of us has its influence on others, and St. Paul reminds its profound significance for us as Christians. Therefore, we read in the epistle of St. Paul, "O death, where is your sting? O grave, where is your victory?" The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 55 to 58. our dearly beloved sister Emilia Turkey lived a life pleasing to the Lord as his beloved spouse and found herself worthy to share in his life and suffering. Standing before her mortal remains this morning, with mixed feelings of grief and pain, joy and victory, I bow my head in humble surrender to the holy will of God, who always does what is best for us. She was a luminous guiding star who has drawn many to Christ through her holy and committed life. She lived in communities radiating the beauty and grandeur of a missionary sister. Sister Emilia Turkey was born on 20th November 1933. As the youngest child of Mr. Augustus Turkey and Mrs. Rachel Topol in a village called Baganpara, Dumni, Assam. Having lost her parents when she was a tender girl of class 2, she was brought up under the care of her elder ones. On a village tour, when Sister Nelly Nunes FMA and Sister Angela Kujur visited her house, they were indeed happy to see this little girl. They suggested the elder brother of young Emilia to admit her in the body at St. Mary's, Guwahati, where she studied up to class 6. Later on, with a great desire to become sister, she joined the congregation of the Missionary Sisters of Mary Help of Christians in 1958. Her dream was made realistic by the Lord on December 5th, 1960, when she made her first profession at Barpeta Road, Assam. Her superiors and companions esteemed her for her gentleness and genuine interest in the welfare of others. She loved her superiors, excelled in her duty, was diligent in teaching and imparting faith. Her fluency in Assamese and Hindi made her affable and acceptable to the people to whom she was sent. She showed great interest in teaching the children. Hence, as a young sister, she was sent for junior basic teachers training at Hauli, Assam, where she successfully completed it. She ventured into the mission field as an ardent and enthusiastic missionary with a deep love for Jesus and the souls entrusted to her care. Her simplicity of life and sisterly approach to the people in the villages were easy means through which she could spread the good news. She also served as a very good assistant in the boarding schools and an efficient teacher to the little ones. Sister Emilia Turkey worked in the places like Dibrugarh, Galahad, Suryapathar, Moranhat, Salana, Lakhimpur, Tirthanbari, Rengapara, Siliguri, Ranchi, Baltikuri, Dumka and Bandel from 2017. Advanced in her age. She always remained cheerful in all circumstances of life with great trust in the one who has chosen her. Sister Emilia is known for her spirit of prayer and hard work, love for the poor, availability and sociable nature. I am not capable of doing big things, but I want to do everything, even the smallest thing, for the greater glory of God, Saint Dominic Savio. I am confident that these words of Saint Dominic Savio is very apt to the life and spirituality of our beloved sister Emilia. She would do all the good she could, to whomever she could, and whenever she could, during her active life. Holy Rosary was her one and only companion. It was her favorite prayer. One would never find her without the rosary in her hand and praying it. I am praying for you was a sincere assurance that she would always give us. In the community, all of us were drawn to her because of the joy she radiated, her humility and simplicity. Sister Emilia was one such extraordinary soul, a personification of virtues, faithfulness and courage. From the time I met her, her simple life and character left an indelible impression on my heart. Through her untiring missionary zeal, unwavering commitment to the rules and regulations of the congregation, and her steadfast adherence to values, Sister Emilia exemplified a life of true purpose and selflessness. Whenever I visited her, she thanked me profusely for all the care she received and assured me of her prayers and the various needs of the province. I met her for the last time during my visitation on last Saturday, the 4th May. Before I left the house, I went to her, gave her a hug, and made the sign of the cross on her forehead. She could scarcely talk, yet gave me a beautiful smile, which was her last message to me, and that will linger on for the years to come. She was becoming weak and passed away amidst prayers and singing in the company of the sisters and aspirants of Ferrando Convent, Bandel, on 5th May at around 7:30 p.m. We are confident that the entire heavens will be waiting for her because she is very much known by Jesus, Mary and Joseph, whom she untiringly called upon day and night. Sister Emilia was an exceptionally blessed person who enjoyed the favor of the Master in an incredible way, which she reflected through her exemplary life of religious consecration. A limb has fallen from the family tree of MSC Kolkata. If Sister Emilia were able to utter her feelings, I believe these would be her words to the sisters, to each one of us who surround her at this moment. Grieve not for me. Remember the best times, the laughter, the song, the good life I lived while I was strong. Continue my heritage, I am counting on you. Keep smiling, and surely the sun will shine through. My mind is at ease. My soul is at rest. Remembering all, how I truly was blessed. Continue traditions, no matter how small. Go on with your life. Do not worry about faults. I miss you all dearly. So keep up your chin. Until the day comes, we are together again. As you sit on your final journey, dear Sister Emilia, you leave behind a powerful message to live our lives to the full in love and service, to love passionately, to give generously, to work tenaciously, to discipline the self perseveringly, always spreading the joy of the gospel, and to go till the end unflinchingly until we lay down our life completely for the Master. With an ever radiating smile, you went around doing good without counting the sacrifices. You were ever joyful and pleasant in your dealings, dedicated and generous in service, friendly and motherly in relationships, straightforward, humorous and simple in your approach to everyone. You would welcome everyone with your friendly and ever beaming smile. You were a person without guile, simple in dealings and frank in expressions. As your health deteriorated, you accepted the situation without any complaint. You spent your last days praying for the various needs of the congregation and the province. In life and in death, you witnessed Christ and have run your race to the finish. May you receive the crown of glory prepared for you. We remember you always by the beautiful and serene smile on your face. We will certainly miss you, dear Sister Emilia, and calling you lovingly Nani in our community, but you will continue to live in our memories. We remain grateful to you for being a faithful daughter of our mother congregation who loved her with all sincerity and worked hard to make her grow in missionary vitality and holiness. Thank you for being a genuine religious and authentic missionary. We entrust you to the mercy of the Lord that He may welcome you to the bliss of heaven for which you were destined from all eternity. May you enjoy the company of the Blessed Virgin, whom on earth you venerated as your loving mother. May our beloved father and founder, Venerable Stephen Ferrando, and our pioneers, who are already enjoying the glory of God, welcome you to our growing MS-MHC family in heaven. Pray for us, dear Sister Emilia, and intercede for us from Jesus to guide our path on our journey towards eternity. Adieu, dear sister, till we meet at Jesus' feet. We will certainly miss our dear sister Emilia and her angelic presence amidst us. May her soul rest in peace.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Very beautiful way, Lord Jesus. To us, it is so to say a really effective life that she lived until the old age. I think she died by 94, 91. She died 91, nothing. But she lived it gracefully. She, so to say, as we say, get old gracefully, and she, to the day, till the day, she was graceful in her life. So as we contemplate her passing away from us, let's call to mind at this Eucharist, at the beginning, to recollect ourselves, to reconcile first with the Lord for our shortcomings, our faults, our failures, our mistakes, our weaknesses that pervades us day in and day out. At every Eucharist, the Lord invites us first to reconcile with Himself, so that we are able to take part in this Eucharist in a worthy way. Hence, let's call to mind our sins and present them to the Lord and ask for forgiveness and mercy. I confess to Almighty God
and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, to my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who alone are able to give life and death, free your servant Emilia from all sins, and she who believed in the resurrection of your Christ, may when the day of resurrection comes, be united with you in glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The righteous man, though he die early, will be at rest. For old age is not honored for length of time, or measured by number of years, but understanding is gray hair for human beings, and a blameless life is ripe old age. There was one who pleased God and was loved by Him, and while living among sinners, he was taken up. He was caught up, lest evil change his understanding or guile deceive his soul. For the fascination of wickedness obscures what is good, and roving desire perverts the innocent mind. Being perfected in a short time, he fulfilled long years, for his soul was pleasing to the Lord. Therefore, he took him quickly from the midst of wickedness. Yet the people saw and did not understand, or take such a thing to heart, that God's grace and mercy are with His elect, and He watches over His holy ones. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah. Paul to the Corinthians, "Brethren, we know that if the tent, that is our earthly home, is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in heavens. So we are always of good courage. We know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yes, we are of good courage, and we would rather be always away from the body and at home with the Lord. So, whether we are at home or away, we make it our aim to please Him. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive what is due for what he has done in the body, whether good or evil." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel acclamation.
Jesus told Philip,
that there is no kind in him. Sister Emilia was a person looking at who said, here is a person who had no kind in him. That you can vouch for yourself. Today we are facing with the reality. What reality are we facing? We are facing the reality of death. And also life that is birth. Birth and death. By the very fact we are born, we have to die. There is no way out of escaping this reality. But how many of us really think of this reality? Anyway, one reality is this, but have you ever realized in death, in birth, what happens? In death, what happens? Have you ever thought? Here we are facing the death. Death of Sister Emilia. You are very sorrowful, very sad at her passing. You are tearful. Many of you might have said tears when at his side. At the beginning you were there. And really, but to your astonishment, ever you realized that Sister Emilia, after death, everybody you can see a glowing face, fresh face. I have seen all the persons, so to say, after death, becomes face so fresh and so nice. Why is this? To my thought, thinking of this and all these things, see, in death, we are sad. But the person who died, going away from us, he is or she is not sad. Quiet, peaceful, so nice. Doesn't say a word. Why is this? What did you find out? Because we also know. And the gospel we read, Jesus said, don't worry, after your coming, they said, lot of rooms in my Father's house. Naturally, after death, we go to Father, and there with the Father, and we forget everything that we are from this world. We don't remember anything when you go up and we are in such a situation and that makes you forget everything. Father, Jesus, Mary are facing. You think that we'll think of the place for where we came from? For the person, people we have left behind? No, we are no human beings. We are a soul. At the same time, what happens at the birth? In birth, all of us are very happy. We really cheers, says the mother to the father, and father, congratulations. Such a beautiful child. And the child is, what is happening to the child? Child is crying. The child is born and all this is most of the time they're crying. Have you ever realized why this child is crying? I know, it is my conclusion and I feel that the child, from where the child is coming to fulfill the wish of God in this world, finding in the midst of us are very strange and seeing such a miserable situation, start crying. And so, crying, and the others are very happy. Why the others are happy? There is another miserable one came to share our misery. So very happy, there is another more to share. So this is how, so to say, connotation between death and birth. And we have to celebrate both. Whatever death is, we celebrate the birth, gift of God to us, and we celebrate the death, giving the gift of God to God. This is our duty, that's why we met together, been together to give God, give back what God had given to us, especially the soul of the person and also the physical appearance. So today is another thing, is not a day to be sad, to be sorrowful, to be tearful. Why? Nisha said, and God, you Christians say that you are saved. You are saved because Jesus Christ had come and saved you. And then he said, why are you sad again? If Jesus has saved you, Jesus is with you, you should be always happy. But you are sad. Poet Robert Browning, writing a poem on happiness and sadness, just 8 lines, and he said, when I walked with happiness all the way we chatted, and at the end of it I learned nothing from happiness. For when I walked with a sadness, all the way we were silent. Not a word was said. At the end, oh, what a thing I learned from sadness. In happiness, we do not learn thing. Happiness is a party. We come to a party, celebrate and rejoice and all these things. We do not think, we do not reflect, we do not recollect, nothing. But in sadness, when you sadness, when someone passes away, that is the time the sadness speaks to us. Each individual, the sadness will speak to each individual as it is. And that is the face reality that we face with. And sadness, we learn things. In sadness, we learn things. But not in happiness. And today as you face a sad reality in your community, this sadness of reality should teach you something from the life of Sister Emilia. You should reflect, this person had lived among us. What positive thing can we get of her life? What positive aspect of their life we can get of her? Certainly, she had really lived many times positively, many ways, energetic, positive life that she had reflected when she lived. It is our time now to reflect by ourselves, to see how Sister Emilia reflected in the sadness, in the negative reality, how she took things into positive. So, my dear, loneliness and sadness is a thing from which we are given a chance to learn, either for good or for bad. How is it we learn either good or bad? Loneliness, sadness will take you either something very positive or something very negative. At the death of a husband, a wife was really cheerful beside herself. And I overheard around an older lady putting her head around over her shoulder and saying, "My dear, my dear, today is a really a trial day for you. To give you an example, I tell you, today you have been put into hot water, boiling hot water. As we change egg, which is hard, as we take egg, which is fragile, as we take potato, which is hard. If you put both the eggs and the potato in the hot water, what happens? It happens that egg becomes hard, boiled egg. And what happens to potatoes? It becomes soft. So my dear, lady saying, my dear, so and so, today you are in the hot water. Either you will come out of it a boiled soft potato, or you will be come out of it hot boiled egg. What does mean? That your heart, either it will become very soft, understanding and all these things, death will lead you to, or this layer, death, will lead you to hard boiled egg. That means your heart will become hard stone. You will never look at people with cordiality, with affectionate, with a smile, unless and until you have become soft potato. The reality of death that we face, isn't it, especially when one of our dear ones passes away, what is our reality at the beginning? Unless the person comes out of it, will not able to face the reality. One person really makes me really feel that came out of this reality was Don Bosco's mother, Mama Margaret. When she has to face with a little Don Bosco 2 years, taking him at the side of the coffin, he said, "Your father is no more." How did she take it? If she was depressed, it was really sad, then things would have ended. Don Bosco would not have been Don Bosco. But she became really a soft potato, and Don Bosco became what today is because of her handling the situation in spite of losing her right hand. This is the reality of our death and our birth. Let us live this thing. We are called, everybody of us, are called to live this reality. And let us live this reality. God's gift to us, the God has given a life to us, and we have to give back this life to Him. Let us always think, I am a gift of God, and I must give myself to God. May with the death of Sister Emilia, may also we learn the lesson that with her, may we try to get age gracefully rather than so many negative realities that comes on our way and we get stuck to it and our life becomes a real negative rather than a positive reality, positive energy of Jesus who always gave us that energy of life for our soul. May Sister Emilia, reaching heaven, we ask her to pray for us. At the same time we ask, pray for Sister Emilia to Jesus that whatever may have happened, that reality that you know, give our Sister Emilia long lasting life with you. God bless you all.
For Pope Francis, bishops and priests, that the Lord may uphold them at all times to become clear evidence of God's love and compassion in their mission of preaching Christ to build up God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Father Thomas Gomes and all the concelebrants of this Holy Eucharist, that as they share in the ministerial priesthood of Jesus, they may be the living flames of the divine love, giving Christ love to all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the departed soul of Sister Emilia Tilke, that the Lord, who is infinite in mercy and love, purify your soul from all imperfections through this Eucharistic celebration. May all our prayers and supplications be a source of merit to obtain paradise. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the relatives, friends, well-wishers and all those who remember and pray for her, that they may experience the comforting love of the Lord. May they be consoled at the thought that she lives in the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Superior General, Sister Christine Minson, the General Councillors, Provincials, their Councillors, and each member of our congregation, that we may strive after holiness and work wholeheartedly for the glory of God and salvation of souls. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us present here, that the thought of entering into the beatific vision at the end of our life and being with Jesus in heaven for all eternity may enable us to live our Christian life faithfully to accomplish God's mission. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord our God, we offer up these prayers of intercession to you, all that is needed for our salvation of ourselves. Please grant us, you know the best. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bring to you our offering of bread and wine.
pray, brothers and sisters, that yours and my sacrifice may be accepted, God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Almighty and merciful God, by means of these sacrificial offerings, wash away, we pray, in the blood of Christ, the sins of your departed servant, Emilia, and purify unceasingly by your merciful forgiveness those you once cleansed in the waters of baptism. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. In a similar way, supper was ended. He took the chalice and once more giving thanks and said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. mystery of faith. And recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make your person eternal and lawful unto you, with his soul and your faith and intercede with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence you rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation be pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity of the Green Church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Thomas our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, our merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant, Sister Emilia, Dirky, whom you called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who have listened to at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. And seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Jesus, come into me.
For the sanctification of the soul of Sister Emilia Turkey, we shall listen to the message of Sister Christine Minson, the Superior General, who expresses the collective sentiments of love and gratitude to Sister Emilia Turkey on behalf of the congregation, delivered by Sister Mary Fedovanal, the Assistant General.
Be faithful until death, and I will give you the crown of life. Revelation 2:10. Dear fathers, sisters, friends, benefactors, family members and relatives of our beloved Sister Emilia Turkey, I am here to convey the heartfelt condolences, gratitude and prayerful accompaniment of Sister Christine Minson, our Superior General, and to deliver her message as we bid goodbye to another pearl of great price who has accomplished her earthly journey and have reached back home to the Father. This precious pearl, Sister Emilia Turkey, lived in simplicity, goodness and gentleness, radiating the fragrance of tenderness. The physical absence of such a person certainly evokes a sense of loss, especially in the members of Calcutta province who shared her life more closely. I wish to express the solidarity of the General Council and every member of our congregation with the province of Calcutta as you live through the reality of the sense of loss. with the homegoing of Sister Emilia Turkey. Just a month ago, we bade goodbye to another holy soul, Sister Teresa Langu, who sanctified herself and the congregation through her intense suffering. Now we are here by the mortal remains of beloved Sister Emilia Turkey. As human beings living in flesh and blood, we feel the pain of having to say goodbyes to our dear sisters and other loved ones as they move away from our presence. But beneath the cover of sadness, there is the sweet assurance of an eternal home prepared for us, where the best of all fathers waits with eager longing and outstretched arms to receive every one of us into the joy of unending communion with Him and everlasting happiness. Our saintly Sister Emilia's humble life of 91 years, the dedicated services of her religious life, and her gentle passing away into eternity reminds us of that hope. By the way she lived, she made herself ready to receive the crown of life from the Lord Himself and be ushered into His everlasting presence. I have always found her with a smile on her lips. Faithful until death she lived, that the earth could not hold her any longer. She did not belong to the earth, but to heaven. A beautiful life worthy of imitation. At a very young age, she experienced the loss of her parents and missed them painfully. The Lord favored her and inspired the Salesian sisters to take her to their boarding school in Guwahati, where she continued her studies and finally joined the congregation of the Missionary Sisters of Mary, Help of Christians. She had the joy of having in the congregation her own aunt, Sister Blanchina Turkey, who was one of the 6 foundation stones of the congregation, and Sister Josephine Topper, her first cousin. During the 64 years of her religious life, she served the Lord in the congregation, mostly as a frontline missionary. Her passion for mission was visible to everyone. Recalling the years she lived in the mission, she said on 9th April 2005, "Though I did not study much or have not acquired any degree, the mighty hands of God and the constant prayer support of my parents have led me all through my life as a religious in His vineyard, winning warm friends for Him." This humble handmaid of the Lord, Sister Emilia, was able to see God's goodness and His works even in difficult and trying situations. She believed that the good Lord turns everything into good for those who love Him. Being a person of integrity, she lived her life in faith. She was a loving, compassionate, kind and serene sister who shared her life mingling with everyone and worked her way to win many friends for Christ. Her sole purpose in religious life was to win more souls for Christ. No trials could stop her from fulfilling this desire till the end. Like the widow's mite, the offering of her life was total. In places where she lived, communities where she spent her life, and parishes where she worked all had a place in her big heart. Sisters and people, young and old, men and women, kids and children, all found a home in her missionary life. Beloved Sister Emilia, what fire, what zeal, what passion you manifested in your years of missionary journeys. You were a true missionary sister in fact and spirit. The whole congregation salute you for the daring and undying spirit you held within your fragile body. At this time, when our congregation embarks on a new journey, resolving to live in total fidelity, acharism and spirit, you are one of the valiant missionaries we can look up to for inspiration and challenge. Your kind deed of bringing thousands of souls to Christ through your unflagging zeal tells us that nothing is impossible for the one who loves Christ and is on fire with thirst for souls. Beloved Sister Emilia, today our congregation stands on the foundation made strong by our pioneers, of whom you were one. Support us from heaven that we continue your missionary legacy of building and strengthening God's kingdom. Dear sister, even in death you taught us. You breathed your last gently. You went as you lived, serene and calm, absolutely fulfilled. Thank you, dear sister, for being part of us. As we lay your mortal remains to rest, we pray that God, in His abundant mercy, reward you with the crown of life that has been prepared for you. As the angels carry you home, we hold your memory close to our hearts. Do continue to intercede for us. And you, beloved Sister Emilia, until we meet again. Sister Christine Minsong, Superior General.
We now have Sister Jacinda Jarwa, the Superior of the Community of Toronto Convent of Bangor, to express the collective sentiments of the community to our Sister Emilia and to thank everyone who has expressions of God's love to her in numerous ways.
Those we love never truly leave us. Death is an inevitable reality that all of us will face one day. Though frightening, yet the thought of eternity comforts us, and our faith in the Lord Jesus enables us to accept this reality with hope. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything. As I stand here before the mortal remains of our dearly beloved Sister Emilia Turkey, these words are apt to describe her personality. Always happy and trusting, giving peace to everyone by her gentle presence. I am indebted to God for having been given her as a community member. She sanctified a community with her simplicity, humility, cheerfulness, and joy, concern for others, right humor to enlighten the situations, and to accommodate persons into her loving company are some of her outstanding virtues. I truly believe that Jesus found her to take her to himself during this special month, which is dedicated to our Blessed Mother. is only because she is an ardent devotee of our Blessed Mother. Rosary has never left her fingers, and frequently she used to kiss the crucifix. Without any complaints, she spent her time in the sick bed. Those who visited her never went unhappy, but renewed and smiling, for having been met a saintly soul. She always inquired about others' well-being by asking, "Have you eaten?" And she was generously offered all that she had. She was very fond of sweets. With a sweet smile, she accepted the sweetness of others. She enjoyed good health, except the weakness of old age. Without much struggle, kissing the crucifix with a tear in her eyes, she bade farewell to each of us. She was lucky to be assisted by the candidates and the sisters in her last moments. Surrounded by her dear sisters, her soul with smile gently flew to another sweet home of hers, where her spouse awaited her with open arms. She glorified God by living a fuller life on earth and continues to ignite the minds of M.S. Macy through her exemplary life. She lived for others with a motto, "Others before self." Sister Emilia Turkey always used to say, "Jajisu, long time no see, thank you," putting God first and seeing God in others, making another feel at home in her company and remain as a person of gratefulness. So, on behalf of our dear Sister Emilia Turkey, I would like to convey the same to all of you present here. Thank you to each one of you present here. Thank you for all the prayers you offered for her. Adieu, Sister Emilia, till we meet again in heaven.
I now invite to suggest Jacinda Bengara, our Vice Premier, to propose the word of thanks.
I have fought a good fight. I have finished the rest. I have kept the faith. 2 Timothy 4:7. We are deeply grieved at the passing away of our beloved sister. At the same time, we are consoled at the thought that the door of heaven is wide open to receive her soul, who is now enlisted as a permanent member there. I stand here on behalf of the province of Kolkata, our community over here, and of our dear sister Emilia Turkey. I extend my heartfelt thanks to all of you who have come from far and near to pray from Sunday till today. Since the announcement of the death news, you were with us to support us and to pay the final homage to our dear sister. Reverend Sister Meritha Bunnell, the Assistant General, Reverend Sister Daisy Jacob, the Economist General, Sister Rose Paite, former General Counselor, Sister Sini Matthew, the Provincial Superior of Mary Immaculate Province, Kolkata, Sister Annie Sebastian, the Provincial Economist, Sister Meena Tirki, the Provincial Counselor for Evangelization, Reverend Father Thomas Gomes, Assistant Parish Priest of Grande Basilica, Father C.J. George, Father P.B. Matthew, Father Dennis, sisters, relatives, friends, well-wishers and benefactors of MSMHC and of Sister Emilia Turkey. And all of you present here, your presence has certainly enriched this ceremony of bidding farewell to our dear sister Emilia. I wholeheartedly thank Reverend Father Thomas Gomes, the main celebrant, for presiding over the Holy Eucharist and praying for the repose of our soul. Thank you for the many blessings you imparted on her from this altar. Our gratitude knows no bounds as we recollect the love and support we experience from Reverend Sister Christine Mensong, our Superior General. Though she is not present with us, we have Sister Mary Carbonell, the Assistant General, and Sister Daisy Jacob, the Economist General, on behalf of the Superior General. We feel blessed to have you and thank you for your generous availability. We are thankful to all our dear sisters in the congregation, particularly to the general councillors and provincials of the provinces for their support and praise. We say a lot of thanks to Sister Rose Paite for being here. We can't but articulate our heartfelt gratitude to our provincial, Sister Sini Matthew. Her time-to-time visit to Sister Emilia was really life-giving. She was here at Bendel yesterday onwards, seeing to every minute details of the proceedings of the funeral and guiding the sisters. Her presence and person is valued much. We thank God for her. Thank you, dear Sister Sini. We sincerely acknowledge Sister Annie Sebastian, Provincial Economist, for her assistance to get the logistics in place for the funeral service. Thank you, dear sisters, for your availability and sacrificing spirit at any point of time. We are grateful. We thank the members of the Provincial Council for being present on this day and all their generous services and support towards the smooth conduct of today's proceedings. We are immensely blessed with the assistance we received from the Fathers in Bendel Basilica. We thank you for being there for us at all times. You were with us yesterday onwards, praying and offering Holy Mass for our dear sister. Thank you, dear Fathers, for making it possible. We greatly value your generous gesture of love shown to us. We also thank Father Anil Tokpo, the rector of Don Bosco Seminary, for the timely help which helped our dear sister Emilia to receive the last sacrament. He was there like an angel to assist our sister to receive Jesus before her home going. We also thank all the Fathers of Don Bosco Seminary for all their support and in various ways. We are truly grateful to the relatives of our dear sister Emilia. Though she lost her memory, that didn't deter you from visiting her. She will always be with you in spirit and will spend her heaven interceding for you. A sincere note of thanks to our dear sisters from the neighboring communities for the solidarity shown to us at the loss of our dear sister Emilia. Thank you for your valuable prayers, your presence with us yesterday onwards, and also today as we part with Sister Emilia today. We also thank our dear sisters for traveling from far and coming near to express your love and care for Sister Emilia. You help the community here in preparing everything for our dear sister Emilia. With deep appreciation, the province gratefully acknowledges the generosity and selfless sacrifices the community of Fernando Convent Bendel. Sister Jacinta Jerwa, the Superior, sisters, aspirants, children, domestic and support staff who gave their maximum service in assisting Sister Emilia Tirki. A special note of thanks to Sister Monica Hokip, Miss Sushila, for taking good care of our sister during her illness. We thank Dr. Robert Lakra and the medical staff for graciously accepting our call in time of need. May God bless their selfless sacrifices. We sincerely thank our gracious parishioners for being with us in time of pain and loss. You have been our extended family members. A special note of thanks to Mr. John Marji and Mr. Sanjay, the Parish Council Secretary and Member, for helping us to get a place at the mobile mortuary. We are grateful to Mr. Rajkumar Seth for his support. He is always there for us as our extended family member. We are immensely grateful to Mr. Sergius for helping us with the videography and photos. You are always there for us. God bless you for your generosity. Thank you to each of you who let go of your scheduled programs to avail yourself to attend this funeral service. Thank you, one and all. Let us be assured that Sister Emilia Tirki, who has reached her real home, will now definitely intercede for us from there. May the soul of our beloved Sister Emilia Tirki rest secure in the arms of Jesus. May Mother Mary, whom she venerated here on earth, lead her way to Jesus. Thank you.
I now request Father Thomas Gomes to bless the body of Sister Emilia and pray for her.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our sister to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that we will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give her a merciful judgment and forgive all her sins. May Christ, Good Shepherd, lead her safely home to be at peace with God, our Father. And may she be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of eternal peace. Let's pray silently by ourselves. Saints of God, come to her aid, come to meet all angels of the Lord. Receive his soul, receive her soul, and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. Angels lead you to Abraham's side. Give him eternal rest, O Lord, and may your life give her eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on her forever. Receive the soul and present him to God. Father, into your hands we commend our sister. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, she will be raised to life on the last day. And I will come to the altar of God, the God of my joy, my Redeemer. I will thank you all on the heart of God, of my God. Our response is, into your hands we commend our sister, O Lord.
Into your hands we commend our sister, O Lord.
Why are you cast down, my soul? Why groan within me? Hoping God, I will raise him still my Savior and my God.
With your hands we commend our sister, O Lord.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made a holy grave of all who believe in it. And even though their bodies lie in the earth, and trust that they, like you, will rise again, we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May I request all the fathers to pause for a photo near the mortal remains of our sister Emilia. Now we shall pay the final homage to our dear sister Emilia. I request you to come in two rows and offer flower petals as soon as the mortal remains of sister will be carried in the ambulance. I can see you proceed to Calcutta for the interment.
Our love abides forever.
Jesus, see His mercy. and griefs to bear. स्वामी सुचरवा निकाह मुझ पे तेरी सदा
चरवा निकाह Lord.